Hi guys, welcome to Film Companion South. So we're talking today a day after your film, your real proper indie film has made it to Amazon, and it's getting a lot of good reviews, including I personally like the film myself. So first of all, what's the mindset like right now? Like all that hard work is done. I read about how you guys had to shoot in the snow for 15, 16 days together. Now that it's finally out and people are watching it, like what's your mindset like?
It's really fantastic. Honestly, it hasn't sunk in yet. So as we already discussed, the reports are pouring in. We are super, super stoked with all the, you know, positive reports, especially from the national media, the attention we are gaining. We need that kind of traction, especially being the indie maker. Amazon has already done half the job. The next half is, you know, how can we all come together and support movies like us and take it to all the households? Because we are pretty sure our movies, you know, has that universal appeal, and it can definitely impress all sections of audience.
I'm very surprised by everyone liking the film and supporting the indie film. So I'm just loving it, and it gives us support to do more and more this kind of films. So even I think later in the future also, I can push more budget into the movies so that people will support different oriented concepts. Yeah, you get to see me doing those in future. It's a moral support which I got from all the reviewers. That's what I need.
Well, I tell you, I mean, this is beyond my wildest dreams. But having said that, when we started this project, I didn't have an iota of doubt of which direction it will go, the kind of quality, the output, you know, we will get. It was just a question of execution at that point. And given the journey I had with Kiran, I've known him for 5 years. So I have like that confidence that Kiran can execute it. And then along the way comes Srujan, right? He's been the true backbone for us, really, really supporting us. And the majority of the success goes to him, apart from Kiran. So all these things adding to one to another, I think here we are, you know, after, a, you know, I think opening day reviews, if you will, right? We're getting some real, real good reviews. It's just overwhelming. It's just overwhelming. I just can't even put it into words.
So let's start with this question I've always had about Telugu filmmakers, especially Telugu filmmakers who have really good jobs in the US. What happens to your career? So what happens to your mindset maybe 5 or 10 years after you guys move to the US, where I find so many people getting bitten by the cinema bug, you know, starting from Nagesh Kukunoor. It's so common. And in most cases, you see them kind of leaving everything and coming to Hyderabad and starting off there. But at least in your case, you guys decided to stay there and make your film there. So tell me about that phase in your careers where you feel like, oh, we need to do something more, or we need to make movies. Just tell me about that.
So what I feel is there are a lot of people in the US who wants to make movies, and because of the profession or because of the toughestness of to make a film back in India, because you have to go find a producer there. Once they come to the US, they get a secure job and they get some savings. It's easy. Then they start thinking that, why can't I make a movie there? So, but we don't have enough resources back in the US to make an indie film. And we have a lot of limitations here because we don't have known actors. We have to find this. When Kiran started this movie, it's the same problem we had. We didn't know if a cast can come from India to do a movie here. And since everyone are new, whether they will support or not, these are all the limitations we had. So we thought, why don't we approach in such a way that make a movie, show it to the people, and from here I can find newer filmmakers back in US can start working it, and there'll be a person who can promote and help them to make the films. And this should be an example. You don't need to go back to India to make movies. You have an opportunity to make in US itself with a different type of concepts. That's what I felt, and I want to support these people, saying that if you have a good story to tell, you don't need a language or a restriction or a country barrier. You can make a movie wherever you want.
Yeah, I can add a couple of things to that. So as Srujan mentioned, once we move to the US, obviously, you know, you can save an extra dollar so that, you know, you can invest into what you really are passionate about. apart from that, your life is, well, I will not call it mundane, but it is pretty much mechanical, right? So you don't have any external influences or factors that would disturb your day-to-day routine. So once you go to office, it's just 8-to-5 life. Once you come back, of course, you have a family, but everything is planned and you don't have any external disturbances. Back in India, I mean, I'm not saying have those things, but, you know, population, traffic, you know, a lot of other disturbances. I mean, I don't think you'll have space to even invest into other creative aspect of your, you know, left brain. Once we settle down here, I think that is where people start thinking, hey, we have this passion. Now that we have time as well, why don't we, you know, explore, you know, what we really are passionate about. And what we did differently this time is, you know, doing entirely the production, you know, the filming, the pre-production, the post, everything until the release part, everything in the US. We did not quit our professions. We tried to manage, you know, both boats without rocking them. That didn't happen overnight. We had to build it over the course of 8 years. So we started doing short films in 2012 with just two-man crew, myself and my associate Harsha, with just one camera and then one actor. But we did all the 24 crafts. Well, I did just 23 into the acting part. But that is how the experience has been built. And then in 2018, we realized, hey, we have enough experience to at least, you know, start something at the indie scale. We were not panicked or we didn't, I mean, we were pretty solid, okay? We know what to do. Execution part, yes, I mean, we'll always face those logistical challenges, but we had a clear, you know, understanding of how this is going to shape up. And cut to that, we didn't really worry about going back to India because we know what to do and where to shoot. And stuff like that in the US itself.
I think there is a fundamental answer to your question here. Why do these Telugu people after 10 years, you know, try to switch, right? It's not actually after 10 years. I think the Telugu people have more of a cinema bug than other states or, you know, other speaking, you know, you see, Tollywood is like by far the craziest, you know, cinema producing, you know, industry, if you will. And there's a reason. Because, you know, growing up, you would see, like, you know, even the hardest working, let's say even a person who do you know, does rickshaw, right? His main way of entertainment is he comes back dead tired at 12 o'clock. He watches a first show or a second show movie, goes to sleep. That is the form of, so we are crazy about movie. So it's not that it starts after 10 years. It's the bug's always there. You know, as soon as the avenue opens up, which probably does for anybody after 10 years of having been solid in a career, you know, having, you know, become stable. I think that's the fundamental reason, that bug in Telugu people.
So, Kiran, let me start by asking this. Like, everybody, like, at least 90% of the people associated with this film, are there people that you kind of met through this filmmaking or short filmmaking process? And how did you kind of build this network, you know, of like-minded people to which ended up with Gautam today?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I already mentioned, I can't stress on this because this is a process, right? So we didn't start this overnight. So right when I started short film making, I already figured out my crew. They started along with me. We did 13 short films, a web series, and a couple of commercials. Half of them didn't even see limelight, and, you know, whatever has seen limelight, half of them were terrible. At least for me, because, you know, as a filmmaker, I want to do better than the previous one. Having said that, we gained a lot of experience out of it, a lot of, you know, on-field, on-set experience. So during this course of time, my crew has been figured out. It's, you know, my wife is also supportive. She runs the production design and the set most of the times. And coming to the cast, so I started my journey with Bhargava in 2015. So he found out my works from one of his, you know, colleagues or friends, through mutual friends. And then he has, as already mentioned, he had that bug because he comes from the theater background. And then we started our journey there. And then I figured out, okay, I have this nice connectivity with him. And then once I, you know, started writing the story for Gautam, I figured out, okay, I know whom to cast with my, you know, limitations and constraints. Bhargava, I think, is the best choice, and he actually excelled than what I actually originally anticipated. And coming to the other cast, Rakesh, the other lead actor, I mean, he already did 20-30 short films. I've been following him for almost 8 years, but we started our journey, you know, in 2017. I've been observing him, his interests, his strengths, and, you know, what can he bring in addition to the table. That's how, I mean, it was not again an overnight thing. I traveled along with him because that is really important. And then the same goes with other, you know, any new cast or crew we added upon. The connection is really important because once you plan something at this scale for a movie like Gotham, like an indie movie, you cannot function like a team. You have to function like a family. You know how family treats each other, right? So irrespective of how many long hours you run, we are always focused and determined to finish the product no matter what. That kind of push comes only if you own the product. So the team I built and the people who work along with me absolutely were all part of the plan. So it's not like, you know, we onboarded someone overnight. We did that for, you know, a couple of crew people, like the technicians, you know, sound folks or the camera folks. That has to happen because we cannot, I mean, I didn't have those because we were handling those in the past. So apart from that, yes, to answer your question, yes. I mean, they were all part of the journey of the span of 8 years.
What do you guys do? Like, what kind of jobs do you guys have in the US and where are all of you based? Are you all to one coast or is it spread across the country?
I can answer this. We are all spread across the country. I live in Bay Area. Ian Barger lives in the Bay Area. Karen lives in Arizona. The Hasha lives in
Delaware.
Rakesh lives in Houston, the actor. So these are all our different places. And I used to work for Facebook for 3 years and right now working for a startup called Amada Health. And Bhargavaya works for Google, I guess.
I'm doing, I'm optimizing the machine learning stack for Google. So I'm an engineering program manager there. Started in January. I was there for a short stint at Facebook before, but it's all been tech, you know, building products and, you know, that is also a passion. But if you call a bug is acting or, you know, film, you know.
If you see, there is a common factor we bring to the table, right? So the program management and the project management. So irrespective of us being in different locations, we still have to coordinate on a daily basis. So we have our daily stand-ups to share the updates on what the movie and where the movie is. And also, how do we manage the time? It's pretty important. It's critical in executing, indie movies like these, right? So we had to be pretty solid on execution part, and that comes from the solid pre-production and planning. We bring all our pretty expertise to the table. Please, Bhargav.
I think the difference we made to the making of this movie is the IT program/project management expertise we have as a bunch. We actually got it down to our production and our production values, right? Actually looking at it with a decision matrix and making, you know, decisions based on data, right? It's you know, we were able to save so much money because of that and cut so much time. I think, I don't know if it'll be followed because, you know, explaining this, then you have to have our kind of background, right? I mean, I can't give that background to everybody, or we can't just transfer that background, right? We come with that background. So that's what we managed to achieve for this film. Efficiency.
Logistically speaking, what was your investment in time before getting done with this project, before getting started with this project? Of course, Kiran, writing can happen on the side. You can always write during the weekends or every day for a little bit of time. But in terms of the leaves that you guys had to take or thinking of maybe even taking a sabbatical, tell me about all those considerations that you guys had to make before getting into Gotham.
Okay, I can start with this. I joined the project in the midway where Kiran already shot for 15 days. They approached me and they gave me an idea of me staying in the US. I've already done 2 movies, so one independent movie as well. So then, and Rakesh is a close friend of mine. Used to live in the same area, and at that time these people shot for 15 days. They took the leave. They totally did that, and we still have 10 to 12 days left, and we have to shoot in different locations. All the cabin episodes have been done in that 15 days. Now we have to move to the second half where we have all the different locations like hospital, police station, road scenes, all the other ones. So what we planned is we shot in the weekends. We have not taken any leaves. We used to fly every Friday and leave every Sunday. And in the span of next 6 months, we did that. So if Monday to Friday we used to plan for the shoot of for the weekends, what's going to happen, and we are very very excited for the weekend. And the thing is, we have to shoot in this in the winter. We have to go back. We have to shoot in the winter. I think one time it was heavy snow pouring up, and even I drove from California to Lake Tahoe in that heavy snow. I remember making that Kiran in the weekend. So we are really crunched of time, and these people used to work 18 hours without sleeping. I was like, these people are totally crazy about that. And because there is a time crunch between, because if we miss it, miss here, and again the budget increases, we have to come back the next week and we have to shoot in the same location. Instead of that, what we did is we spent like 18, sometimes 22 hours in a day, and my DOP is like, no, I have to take a sleep if you have to come back. And we used to sleep, and Kiran wakes up early in the morning again, starts going to the location, wants to see where he wants to put the shot, these type of things. So the plan of
So
like shot in the weekends.
the crux here is, as Kiran mentioned, right? It's the pre-planning. So if you want a glimpse into our pre-planning, it's like we have a daily stand-up call. You understand what a stand-up is, right, Vishal? So stand-up is 10 minutes or 15 minutes or half an hour. It's a call where we're trying to find out where each and everybody in the cast and crew is, right? Okay, you are the editor. Have you edited this? Okay, you are this thing. Have you written what? Okay, well, are the props ready? That sort of fact-finding thing. So every day at 6 p.m. to 7 p.m., somewhere around that time, right? In the evening, we used to have this stand-up. Now, as we approached a schedule, right? 1 week and where we're going to actually do some principal photography, we would start getting into details like, okay, we have this 1 hour slots. What scene, what shots are we going to do in each half hour slots, right? We used to break it down that way. So it was so detailed. And you know, it's like keeping track of all that. And you know, at any point in time over the weekend when you're actually starting photograph, okay, we are supposed to be at scene 23, shot 3. We are not there. Okay, we are 2 shots. Okay, we got to make it up. So even the actors know, like, you know what? So that's the kind of efficiency I think we achieved with this. But that's been our life for the past 2 years.
I'll conclude this by adding a couple of interesting facts. So before even we started making Gatham, we knew we cannot have bigger span in terms of actors or anyone, as per a matter of fact. So when we planned for the first schedule before Srijan sprung into the action, that was the lengthiest schedule, right? 17 days, and we knew we wanted to shoot that in the winter backdrop. But I cannot go after people saying, hey, you need to take a 17-day sabbatical. Well, I can ask two or three people, but I cannot coordinate, 20 or 30 people. So that's where, when we wrote this story, we were cognizant of these facts. If I am planning any lengthy schedules, I have to be practical in coming up with the script and screenplay. So if you since I already watched the movie, most of the filming happens inside a cabin, right? So minimalistic setup, minimalistic actors. That was the kind of approach that was always on top of my mind in, actually, bringing Gotham to, to the audience. So that made our jobs easier. So it was all planned, considering all these facts. So we don't want to run into, over budgeting, over days. Time is again money. So things like that.
But technically, like from what I understand, a lot of you guys are friends or people coordinating, people who have something direct to gain from the film doing well. But how much of how many things or how many cast and crew members did you have to kind of hire from outside? People that you barely know, but people you kind of need to hire because you need their expertise. Was that a big chunk of the budget that you kind of spend on the film? And another question, how tough it is to is it to kind of get permissions to shoot in the US?
Regarding
the first part, please go.
Regarding the crew, the music part is the one we hired. We spent around 10% of our money for the music, a known person, and we have to spend the money on the cameraman as well. He was in US at the time. So some part of them, all the post-production work we have done in the US itself, all the like coloring, sound effects, these are all done by the Hollywood people who have already done a couple of Hollywood films. So those are the ones I think we went out and we put our budget in. And regarding the crew, director, we used to have just 9 people or 10 people in the sets every day. So whoever on screen, they used to shoot and they come back, they become the behind the scenes people working with the director or BOP. So the crew is little, very small, but all the external forces are like, we spent a bit on the quality where at least we don't want to compromise it at that wonderful moment.
Yeah, so my role on the sets especially was a dual role, right? I'm also one of the producers. So I'm the, what do you call the, you know, you asked a very good question. So motivation, right? Okay, I mean, everybody who has to gain will gain, right? And they're obviously motivated. But so it's also part of motivation, right? Understand where Kiran is like getting, you know, stressed out, or Harsha is getting, because these guys are like, I mean, Vishal, you can't imagine the kind of hard work we put, but leave us alone. I mean, the kind of work that Kiran and Harsha put is like humanly impossible, I'll tell you. It's literally humanly impossible. These guys are sleeping maybe 1.5 hours, 2 hours per day. Literally. So, you know, and then they are the most creative guys on the set. So you have to understand how extra they are working, right? So it's our job as the periphery. Not when acting, it's a different thing. But, you know, when not acting, to be the ones who kind of do the other stuff, you know, take care of it, or, you know, if something is, can be done, we just take care of it. But it, as a, you know, I had to, you know, be help with the motivation part itself, right? So, okay, yeah, man, come, let's do it, right? That kind of, just to egg people on. But at the end of the day, you have to understand, any technician who puts his name on this film is also that motivated. If the film comes out well, that's more than a repayment for them. So there is always this synergy. It's just a moment. It's a question of pushing them in the right direction.
Yeah. And adding to that, what these two guys mentioned, right? So most of the budget went into the filmmaking process. So all the cast who were onboarded, they share the same passion, especially the guys from India. I mean, they knew what struggles we go through to make this happen. But obviously, you need to pay to, you know, American actors, because you can't just go and ask them to, you know, just, hey, can you act, because we are passionate. I mean, at least we didn't try that. I don't know if it would work or not. But, you know, but crew, obviously, you need to pay them. And then post-production, you have to invest some money into it. So each and every dollar that we spent on the movie has to be multifold. It has to have that multifold value when it translates or transforms onto the big screen. So most of the production budget went into the making.
What about permissions?
I'm sorry.
Permissions, yes. I don't know if I can disclose that, but, you know, if someone chases after me, you know, Vishal, you're responsible. because most of the filming happened run and gun style. So there was a couple of sensitive locations, you know, where like public library and, you know, a railway station, even railway station, no, but in, you know, a couple of locations where we had to take permission or else it would have been impossible. But other locations, thanks to our minimalistic setup, we were able to pull off, you know, doing the guerrilla style filming. But having said that, we never bothered people except for, you know, 30 or 40 times. still, we had to do it because, you know, we don't know what to do, you know, apart from, you know, making that happen. Well, maybe in this case, Bhargav or Sujan can explain things better, but we had to do a lot of run and gun style filming for the kind of setup we had and for the kind of dream we had.
Yeah. I think one situation where we went to LA, we had a studio where they have sets in the same studio where we shot the police station and the morgue scene. So we hired that set, and it has a pre-built in it, like a police station thing in a old kind of setup. In the next to it, it has a hospital. Next to it, it has a airplane, airport set and all. So we just hired the police station, the hospital, some part of the hospital there. And since the major movie, we have their portions are also in hospital scenes. One of my uncle helped me with his hospital back in Sasta, and we went there and shot there. So we tried to manage it by a couple of times. If we don't have any chance, we hired them, or we tried to even create a hospital set, which it didn't exactly work out, because we didn't have an exact art director kind of thing. here. So I think Kiran's wife itself used to work on the most of the art department as well to get the things right at the right moment. So yeah, we try to reach out our friends and well-wishers here to if we want something, get it done. So in that way, so we spent a little less on the permissions part. We rather shot in a guerrilla style kind of thing. Rather going there, someone comes, just move away. Something like that. Not every time it happens, but most of them. Rest, like the cabin and all, we hired. We hired the cabin for 15 days. Then we hired a different cabin and for again 3 days. So those things are we can't escape from that. So all the ones we done outside, like a railway station and all, we just started there in India.
The key being, where there's a will, there's a way. Now, you have our constraints, given our budget. We just have to find creative ways. I think here, Kiran, I think, mentioned it at least 5 or 6 times. When there are constraints, you got to get creative. And that's exactly what happened, ended up happening for us.
Now, let's go on. Let's go a little deeper into the whole financial bit about this filmmaking, because that's one of the most fascinating things that I find when comparing you guys with the guys who are trying to make films in India. Because in India, you have to kind of go outside. You kind of have to approach a studio or a producer to get your film made. But in the case, like when we talk about you guys, it keeps happening to us. Even when we come across a lot of people who kind of come back from the US, they kind of tell us, do you know a writer? Do you know a director who can make a film? We've got so much money saved up. We've already bought an apartment in India. Now it doesn't make sense for us to simply buy one more apartment which we're never going to live in. And they all have, like you said, that creative bug, the need to do something that's more than just investments or savings or any of those kind of things. But in terms of the pleasure or in terms of
you know what,
joy,
Vishal?
Yeah.
Vishal, I think, you know, if you find more of those people, you should send them to us. We will give them an avenue out.
yeah. So in terms of the creative satisfaction and in the terms of how a filmmaking has kind of helped your quality of life there, how much more can you guys reveal in terms of not just the financial bit, but also the personal bits about getting into something like this there?
The financial bit is like there's a weird arc to the financial bit, right? This is how it all started. Kiran and I have been having this conversation. I mean, we've been in a journey since 2015. We're very close friends. We did a lot of short films together. I understand him. He understands my capability. I totally trust his like end judgment and his capabilities, right? I am 350% sure that we are introducing a new director to the Telugu cine industry. And mark my words on this, right? I mean, you see this genre and let's see when he comes out with a comedy. It'll blow your, you know, seats off, right? That's the quality he brings. So I have this confidence with him. But what we did in 2018 is, you know, we decided it was time to, you know, go over to the next level, you know, start maybe do an indie. That's how it all started. So then we started a banner. But then we just started a banner, we formed a company and all, we wanted to take the movie, but, you know, not that we'd had money. It's just like with pure, like, you know, bullheadedness, Kiran and Harsha, you know, they touched base with all their friends. They did all this groundwork. In the cinema credits, end credits, you'll see like over 100 people mentioned there. And there's a reason. They threw in like, you know, they gave us $100, $500, $50, whatever, right? And then Harsha and Kiran, they put like huge amounts of money into it and they got the first schedule going. This is what happened. And that's the first schedule. And then there was a crunch. Then I jumped in, right? I probably took it out for the one and the next 1.5 schedules. Then we were so lucky to get, you know, Srijan saw the teaser. He loved it. I went and talked to him. He said like, yeah, let's do it, bhaiya, and all. And then it's that he just became the backbone of us, right? I mean, it just took us, anything we asked, we got everything. And that is what ended up happening for us.
Then the music director came in. We wanted to get a new non-music director where they can
introduce. Yeah. I think I remember asking Kiran that, you know, so we were talking about music directors and like, you know, there were several names thrown around. And, you know, it's like, you know, you're already half in the water. Why feel the, you know, let's go all in sort of. I was in that mode. So I asked him, like, if money is not a matter, who do you want music for your movie? right? And Kiran said Sri Charan Pakala. You know, and then I did some digging, called him up. A great guy. He's from Vizag, just like me. So he used the Vizag thing as well. It's not that it's a big of a leverage, but you know, whatever, you know, this thing. And then Srujan talked, one thing led to another. But, you know, I eventually very graciously accepted to, you know, help newcomers. You know, that's a big deal, right? Srujan, I mean, who are we, right? Why does he have to put money on us? He doesn't know us. Well, he saw some spark. He saw the passion that we were doing it with. I think everything falls into place because of that passion, in my opinion.
Anything else?
So at least at that point, when you're all investing like personal savings into this, right? So at that stage where, like you said, like, you know, you get into the second schedule or the third schedule, you guys are putting in personal savings, like money that you could have used for the future or, you know, so many other things. So at that time, in case Amazon hadn't bought it, or in case you guys don't get a theatrical release, had you guys kind of made peace with the fact that, okay, this money is just gone or this money is stuck? I'm talking about little, like, financially. I'm not talking about the emotional, the joy or anything like that. In terms of money.
Yeah, it would obviously be stuck. We were a release. We initially thought for a typical release. Then once the corona scare came in, then we thought, back in, we had this thing that to release the OTT perspective, if the theatricals are not, in March, something that when the corona is happening in China, we had this scare some time in India or US, since we stay in US, right? The cases are slowly rising. We thought there will be some problem. Why don't we approach OTT at the same time? We tried to approach, being a new cast, new crew. No one knows about the movie. There will be thousands of movies in India with new cast and new crew, and everyone feels it's a smaller type of things. What to get noticed? So we need to be noticed by these people. So we approached Netflix, Amazon, Telugu, AHA and all. Everyone were positively replying with something, but they had something called, you know, they don't have a marketing pinch to our film where we can't, you guys are not known, why would an audience watch our film? That's the reason they were interested initially. But later on, again, sometime later when Amazon came back and I said that we saw the movie, we sent a Vimeo link with the movie. The whole thing. Initially, no one saw the movie itself. They just saw the PPT and they just rejecting the movie. Later on, we from a different structure, we tried to push it in. I think Mango came in, then they pushed it, asking them to watch the film. Even I think Z5, Amazon and other people watched the film. The problem is the financial factor. We were just asking them making money, and that's where the question mark was. We just want what we invested in it. And finally, we are happy with what we got.
So coming back to your question about, like, you know, putting savings into this money, I mean, obviously, Kiran put everything he had, Harsha put everything he had, and 150 people probably put, you know, whatever they could afford, right? And then I put a lot of money. And, you know, at that point in time, no, we didn't have any doubt, Vishal. I mean, we were 250% convinced that the quality of the product will be such that it will entice somebody to help us. And that first somebody was Srujan. Right? That first, and we have to give credit to Srujan here, right? He is extremely resourceful. If one thing fails, another thing, it just goes, he's like an energizer bunny, right? So, and finally got us in front of, you know, Amazon, and the rest is history.
Yeah.
Right? So all these things, right? And it's like Kiran's conviction, everything just put, you know, added one to another, and it just happened. But at the end of the day, Amazon wouldn't have taken us, by the way, right? I mean, look, I'm not a known face. Kiran is not a known face. The rest of the actors are not a known face, right? So why did they take us? That's the question we should ask ourselves in this moment, right? I mean, fine, we did all of this thing. Conviction is there, blah, blah, blah. A lot of people will have conviction. What? So what, right? At the end of the day, I think the message we, you know, from be it the cast and crew from Kiran and the crew, or, you know, the lead cast, or from Srujan, content is king. If a distributor watches it and feels it's going to make money, that's when they will put in. It's a pure business decision in my mind. What's the return on investment? And I think we showed some proof of that. And that's and that is why we are here today.
These guys covered a lot of base. well, I'll add one more point. So it was always, you know, mathematically, you know,
fail-safe equation. So no matter what we knew, what, you know, to what extent we can go, especially in the financial terms, to, you know, spend on so many things in so many, you know, areas on our movie. So we always had that, you know, we were cognizant of the fact that we can not overspend based on our, you know, our structure and our popularity in the market. So it's like, okay, worst case, what happens? We prepared for that. So that's where the budget comes from. We always prepared ourselves for the worst case scenario, and our budget cutoff was around 10%, 20% above that line. That's it. So the risk factor, we always try to negate it by thinking about it, you know, well beforehand. So, yeah.
Now, at least after you guys have made this film, do you feel that this network of like-minded filmmakers or, you know, actors, will that process become much easier when you're trying to get into a second film? And when you're thinking of future projects, is this the routine? Like, do you guys want to make Telugu films set in the US or in Canada? Or is there plans of making, like, coming to Hyderabad, making a Telugu film in Hyderabad or, you know, in Andhra, Telangana?
I can start from a producer perspective. I already made two films. I made one more indie film called Hanu, if you heard about it.
Okay.
It's in Netflix. So that's the experience part which I brought into this movie. And I've done a commercial movie back in India with Harika. So I'm doing a couple of movies right now in India right now. A couple of movies which are happening, which are commercial space and indie movies. There are different kinds of movies. But I still, I'm not going to leave the US perspective. I still want to support US. I still support Kiran for the next movie as well. So any people in the US who wants to make things, I'm listening to the scripts as well. So it'll be a tougher part to understand why they want to make. So how the team gels up. So I know the constraints and limitations back in US, what we had. I know how the limitations of not known cast, what will happen. It will be a very tough job to sell our movie without a new cast. Even Amazon, Netflix, anyone, at least they see what the market is. I understand from this movie, saying that, okay, if you have a known cast, it's easy to, even though you have a good story or even though you have a good product, in order to ask them to watch the movie, it will take time. So if you have a known cast, it will be an easy way to go to them, approach them, at least watch the movie, then they can decide whether to go on. So this is from my perspective. I want Kiran also to talk about this. So he's, I want to see, listen to his perspective.
Yeah, why not? So, yes, so adding to that, right? So for me, there are no inhibitions. If we have done with Gautam, it actually stands as an example to any aspiring filmmaker coming from the, you know, film backdrop. It need not be, you know, NRI, or it need not be, you know, whoever is in India. But what the key takeaway here is, you know, the content. So there are in a world of OTT, there are a lot of movies flocking to, they're lining up to be showcased, right? They want to show their talent as well to the world. How do we stand out is what matters. Content is the king. So the reason I mentioned that is, my next move doesn't really depend on how vast I want to expand. So I want to definitely go a notch up, but story has to dictate it. So if the story demands 50% of the budget of what Gautam is, I don't have any problems in doing that. If it really can be done in indie fashion, I'm totally open for that, because I know I can save a lot of money for the producer. And two factors, right? Audience have to love the movie, and producer has to be happy at the end of the day, because he can encourage more talent like us. I mean, there'll be more movies coming if we are successful. So yeah, I mean, it all depends. So the story has to, you know, choose all those things. So that's where it all starts from the director's perspective. Yeah.
Another question, Kiran, going specifically about the bit that we were just talking about. How does it get? Because your process with this film starts before anybody else, and it kind of ends after everybody else, right? So when you talk about kind of managing a proper full-fledged career with the pressures of writing a screenplay, writing dialogues, finding actors, finding money, and then until now, like, I'm promoting the film after it's released. Just can you describe how it kind of like what kind of a toll it takes on your like your work life and your personal life and the kind of time it takes when a project is being worked on?
It's definitely a tough job to manage work life as well as, you know, the personal life. Now imagine we have third life, which is the movie life, right? So how can we achieve what we really dream about is you have to have really good support from the family. So my wife, I mean, we've been married for 3 years. She's my backbone. I don't have to separately mention that. The icing on the cake here is she's also involved in production. So she understands when to give me enough space to, you know, focus on my, you know, screenwriting or, you know, any other pre-production planning that I go through. She gives me total space because she understands, okay, one day, I mean, I'll make it big. So that was the crucial factor for me. But still, you got to do some sacrifices. So we have to like switch off your, you know, office brain after the office is done at 5 p.m. and you have to turn on the movie brain. And then that's your world. That's it. I mean, you cannot really focus on any other aspects if you want to build a career parallelly, right? So you have to be really, really focused on just two things. You can't like throw your legs onto multiple things and, you know, you become jack of all trades, but you don't succeed in any of those, right? So what the example that I at least try to set is, or we set try to set is, you can, you know, achieve your dream, especially in the filmmaking, without doing real sacrifices, by just, you know, doing proper time management and having enough support from the family and friends.
So, Bhargava, sir, like from what I understand, you've done theater, right? You've done theater, like, did you do theater back in India before going there?
Yeah, actually, theater in the sense drama. In school, I did a lot of drama in engineering college. So I participated in a lot of film youth festivals. In fact, we came wherever we used to go and do drama. We used to come first, and this was like we had such a great crew, kind of exploiting all kinds of emotions and all. It was such a great experience. So I had this bug from college, if you will. In fact, I think. I did send some portfolio pictures for some movie, and then it was such an immature thing, I guess, at that point in time, because, you know, you have to have some background to really get selected. And, you know, this is, I wanted to do National School of Drama, and, you know, I thought, I actually sent in an application, and I came back home after my engineering and said, Dad, I want to do some drama. And my dad said, there's the stick, there is Java course, which one do you want to prefer? So I said, okay, Java course, you know, that's what happened. And then C++ followed, and then US followed. So, you know, that's the background, if you will.
So at least in that phase, when you've had a history like this, when you've had like something that you were so passionate about, and when you kind of moved to the US, did you ever have to kind of make a decision that, okay, that is my past, that is over. There's no way I'm going to ever be able to act again. And when such opportunities kind of presents yourself, is it like, what is that feeling like? Because it's kind of like it's like a magical thing, right? It's like going back in time, it's like following your passion, and it's like something that you will not regret later, right? Just tell me a little bit about that part.
So, you know, I came to the US in 2002, and till 2015 it never even crossed my mind that it is even you know, remotely possible that I will act in something, you know, and needless to say, scratch that itch, if you will, right? I mean, you have this itch, you need to scratch it. It just never even remotely occurred to me. And then comes Kiran, right? It's just the thing, stars aligning, I guess, right? So the first thing is Kiran comes into scene. He's playing for my team. He's playing cricket with me. And then I see that he's done this film. It's a small little comedy film, right? But it's done so well that it tells me, right, oh my God, this is exceptional quality, and this guy's got some real talent, right? So then I beg him, like, you know, boss, you know, please, one chance sort of thing, right? Rather jokingly. And then he entertains me, and then one thing leads to another. Our second short film, we got an award. Right, we got an award from two of the biggest directors in Telugu, like, you know, Harish Shankar, Gabbar Singh Fame. He did that is with Pawan Kalyan, right? And then Merlapaka Gandhi. So these were like confidence boosters. But at the same time, to do all of this, I'm taking time away from my family, right? So as Kiran mentioned, you know, the support I got from my wife was, I can't explain it. I mean, it's like yeah, you go do it. You know, who lets people out like this? So it's, I just got so much support from her. She doesn't say much. So it's just that, you know, I'm so lucky, so blessed that I got that support so that I can actually go act and, you know, fulfill this dream that I had since childhood, right? And then Gatham happens. The rest is Gatham.
Last question to all three of you guys. I'm sure like a lot of like Gatham, you know, will inspire a lot of people such as yourselves to kind of go ahead and make the film that they've always dreamt of. Or at least in your case, at least gets start somewhere. You know, start with short film, start with YouTube tutorials and all those kind of things. Not just in terms of the money, but I mean, also I want you guys to also kind of tell them what it means in terms of money and time. But apart from that, what would you tell those guys who are just like, you know, watching Gatham today or tomorrow and then thinking, okay, maybe in 2025, we should have a film on Amazon, or 2027, we should sell something on Netflix. What do you tell those guys?
From a producer perspective, what I want any writer or director concentrate is on the screenplay and the story itself. If he has an engaging screenplay and story, we just ask them to give, we just give them some part of money and ask them to just recreate an important scene by their own people. And if we can execute it, then there's no way we're stopping it. We'll be going at it. So the main thing here will be the screenplay and the story, which I concentrate mostly on.
From my perspective, dream big. Everything is possible. Dream big. Technology is democratizing filmmaking today. You don't have to be a big name. You don't have to have a big star in your film. OTTs and platforms like Amazon they're opening their arms up to unnamed people like us, especially if the content is good. So my advice to like either actors or filmmakers is start small. If in another 5 years or 8 years you want to do something big, start small now. Start making small short films. Understand the craft. And do not rely on others, right? The reason why Kiran is exceptional today is when he made a short film, he would be the cameraman, the guy who edits it, the guy who adds sound, the guy who does music for it, and the guy who cuts the release teaser or the trailer. So having that kind of, or learning that craft, Kiran was not made overnight, right? He started in 2011. So that kind of small improvement, there's a learning life cycle. I think you should start small, aim big, and go towards that. I think you should eke out a path and go towards it.
Vishal, your question a decade ago would have been very tricky to answer. But now that, you know, the entire world is digitized, at least the movie world, right? So the movie has come from the reel to memory card. So you can fit entire movie into a small chip these days. So the technology is at your disposal. There's abundant knowledge on any, you know, media channels, you know, YouTube or any, if Google just for, you know, how to direct a movie or how to title even, how to write or act. So leverage all those resources, right? Come up with whatever your version of story is, whatever your vision is in, you know, bits and pieces. Those are building blocks for your, you know, successful future. But having said that, you have to be a little cautious, right? So everyone has their own creative, you know, perspective or vision of, you know, how a movie should be and how a movie should look. But without proper, you know, preparation, you know, you have to go through that process. You have to make mistakes and you have to learn from those. Get creative each and every time and not repeat those mistakes at all. So you have to go through the process. The reason I say it is, agreed, today OTT platforms are, you know, encouraging a lot of new talent like us. But, you know, if you don't, you know, provide the quality content slowly, you know, OTTs as well as the audience start losing faith in us.
Absolutely,
right? So, we have to be cognizant of that fact. Now, I mean, OTTs are still, you know, kind of new into the Indian market. They're still trying to gauge what audience would really need. In this process, we are, you know, looking towards the OTTs thanks to the pandemic and whatnot. But once people start, you know, consuming the content thanks to all the world cinema, they will slowly, you know, try to understand the quality of, you know, movies coming onto the platforms. They'll start, you know, slowly judging them, and we don't want to lose the steam. OTTs are a boom in, you know, disguise, so we should keep them alive to, you know, support all the young filmmakers like us. So for that to happen, you have to start from A. You have to start from the building blocks and slowly build towards your end goal. I mean, you cannot just throw whatever savings you have into it. Now that I have money, I have crew, I have camera, I have really good actor, I can make a brilliant movie. That won't happen like that. Combinations won't work like that. We have seen a lot of movies fumble like that in recent past. So it all starts with single block and you have to build it from there.
Okay, finally, let's say Telugu movies made in Andhra or Telangana or Telugu movies made in India, they're called Tollywood, right? So what do you guys call Telugu films made in the US? You know, is there something that you, some word that you can come up with for that?
I will say Tollywood. A U at the end, which makes it USA, I guess. Like in Andhra, if it's Ram, you call Ramu.
Yeah, Ramu. Yeah, exactly.
So Tollywood.
What about you, Kiran? Any suggestions?
No, I'm not so creative. I need some time. I'm a slow writer.
He's not so creative. You have to understand it. He's not so creative.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Thanks so much, guys. Thanks so much for talking to us. I'm sure a lot of people will listen to this interview like a textbook. They will study this interview like a textbook so that like you guys, they can also get their dreams made true. Thanks so much for talking, and really looking forward to you guys getting together the same way and making more films for us. And maybe some
thank you,
also. Yep. Glad that you like the movie.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Bye, guys.
Bye.